What's going on, boys? It is another beautiful Saturday morning. So today we are working on Giselle. Once again, we need to get her ready for smog. So we got to pull off her stock, or not her stock. We got to pull off the cold air intake, put the stock one on, put the stock headers. We got new bulbs for the headlights. I showed you guys those in the other video when I was reorganizing my garage. And then we got to do the belts today. Which, you know, I don't know how to do those just yet. I'm pretty sure it's pretty easy, a couple bowls, you know, here and there. So let's get started by taking off this front bumper, because we're gonna start with the headlights, and then we'll probably do the intake while at that. And then next weekend we're just gonna have to take it back off again and then just do the same thing. But for starters, I already showed you my other video how to take it off. Just a couple bolts or a couple things, just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We got one down here, and then I think I actually have an extra one now for right here. And then there's another bolt on this side, and then 3 on the bottom. So yeah.
All right, boys, so I went ahead and took off the headlights already. There's a bolt right here, a bolt right here, a bolt that is on the side over here, and then there's a bolt right here. And then it just comes off. We didn't need to take them fully out, honestly, or take one side off, but I'm gonna clean them. This is where the intake is, as you could see. So we just gotta take the intake off for now. It's gonna go back on the car, but just for smog purposes or anything like that. It's not a carb legal one. So now we're just gonna probably take off the headers up here, take all these bolts off, take off the cold air intake, and then start putting everything on. So all you gotta do is just take off this one right here, like so. I'm trying to do this with one hand and hold the other camera. Jeez, hard. Let's see if it comes off now. No. There we go. Should just come off. There we go. So I'm just gonna dump out from right here. Should be able to get everything through. Yep, like so. And so now you got the cold air intake off. So now we gotta grab the big hunky and ugly one, put that on. So, gotta grab this. I know that this is the bottom box, I think it is, if I'm not mistaken. I wanna say, but I'm not 100% too sure. I don't remember how this shit goes on anyways. But I know it sits in here somehow. So yeah. So now let me grab the other parts so we can start getting this all taken care of. So let's go. All right, boys, stock air box is on. That piece that goes right here, I'm not gonna put it on. Just due to the fact it's just an air feed pickup. So just gets cooler air. But the bottom of the hole's right here. So I'm not too worried about that. It looks stock as it is. Once I put the bumper on, you won't even be able to tell. So now we just gotta get the headers. But before we do the headers, let's see if I can get to these, but I'm probably gonna have to take off the wheel, so no matter what, the car's gonna have to get jacked up. So but I was thinking about detailing the headlights real quick. What do you guys think? Should I? I don't know. Probably not. They're already cool, so I'm just gonna throw them back on the car, because I don't want to spend all day on the Civic. So I could always detail them once I'm done with the car. So we're gonna put the headlights back on. The headlights, the new ones, are right here. Look at these babies. Oh man. Oh yeah. Big boy stuff right here. Oh well, you can't see them. I'll show you.
Alright boys, so this side is in. You can see how bright they are. They're shining through. They're warming up and everything. They're freaking bright. You can see them. Compared to these ones. Yeah. So everything looks good, making sure that they work. So this one's gonna be bright, and then we'll probably clean up the headlights once I'm done, when I have time. So now that we got this on, we're gonna throw this one back on, check the other side real quick. Hold on here so I can show you what it looks like. So this is what it looks like. They have little fans on the back of them. Hold on, I don't think I could do this with one hand. Let's see here. Maybe I can. He's gonna get them. Can you find the hole? Yeah, they work. Cool. So now I just gotta put this one and that one. We couldn't put the little sticky back on, but that's okay, because the actual fans need to spin and everything like that. So in the back, and we want to let those breathe because they are LEDs. So yes, now we get to turn off the lights, and then we can keep on going. So yeah. All right, boys. So we got the headers almost completely off. We just gotta unclip it right here. I completely forgot about this. There we go. Got that off. So now we don't gotta worry about that. So now I gotta jack up the car to get underneath it so we can get the bottom half off. That was pretty easy. I mean, this one's pretty easy too, honestly. Like, they're really easy to get off. So we're almost done with that already. So once we get done with that, then we can start on the other stuff. So, you know, making some good progress here. You know what I'm saying? All right, boys. So the headers are off now. Now we can get the other ones on. So we'll start with this piece right here. We just gotta get the O2 sensor on real quick and slap these bad boys on. Oh, it looks like it has a cylinder already. I thought we took the ones off the other one, but we didn't. So, now I gotta take the screw off to put the O2 sensor, and then we're gonna slam this bad boy in. So, let's do it. All right, boys, so we put the stock headers back on. I wasn't gonna film that because who wants to see somebody putting on stock headers back on? That's boring stuff. But we got the headlights on. We got the factory box on, which has a K&N air filter in there, which is really cool, you know, when I have to do this kind of crap. Then stock headers, so all the performance parts are right here, quarter intake, headers. But we're gonna have to figure something out with these headers though, because they scratch and everything else. So I might just have to do a whole different set altogether. But I got those. I think I picked them up for $20, so that's the only reason why I picked them up. Like with this one, you can see under here, this one hangs up a lot higher. Not only that, but there's like some type of oil leak that I don't know where it's coming from. This right here too does not work. I'm not too sure if it's like this little baby motor right here. I couldn't really tell you guys, honestly. So I mean, maybe it is, because it's the only motor, I think. Because you could hear it turn on the February 2nd or February 26th in 1998. Jeez. Got fluid in here, so I'm assuming it is this little device right here. That's the motor, you know, power ground, trigger. Then, like, comes up and we'll go to these right here. So I'm assuming that it's that little motor right there. So, I mean, if we got a little motor, put it in, probably good to go. So as far as that, I got everything taken care of over here. Now it's going to be, sheesh, what is this? Now it's going to be doing the power steering, all the belts, because she needs new belts. So we're going to start with that, and I'm probably just going to turn my tire. I'm not going to take it off completely because I could see it. Can this come off? I think it can, but I have to pull off everything, and I don't really want to pull off everything. So I'm just going to pull off this little material right here and then just go from there. So let's do it. All right, boys. So now we got to loosen up this power steering. So I want to say there's a bolt right here, and then there's a bolt back there. And then you also have to do the alternator to get that belt. And then I can't remember how to do the AC belt. So we're just gonna start with the power steering and then the alternator belt, because there's a couple bolts that holds on the alternator itself. So let's start with that. So yeah, buddy. All right, boys, so I took off the power steering. Look at this. This is so bad. That's cracking like crazy, and it's hard as fuck. Yeah, so that one's done, but now I just gotta make sure which one's which out of all these. I don't recall, so I just gotta look up, because I know that one is the AC belt, if I'm not mistaken. I don't know. So before I take it off the packagings, I'm gonna have to know which one is what. So yeah, let's keep going. All right, boys, so right here you'll see that there's a bolt right here, right there. That's tensioner. So it's a 10 millimeter. So all you gotta do is just loosen that up to get the main power. And that's not the power steering, that's the AC. And then over here, there is a bolt that's right here. Wait, no, right here. I can't see it, but it's right there. And there's one on the bottom of it too. So we just gotta loosen those up and get those out of the way. So let's go. All right, boys. So I got the one off the alternator off. They're all pretty bad. The only one is the actual AC belt. I have to jack up the transmission or the engine, and then and take off the actual mount right there. So before I do that, I'm just gonna get the alternator one back on because it has nothing to do with that one. So now I just gotta figure out of all three of these, which one's the alternator. I mean, they have codes on these ones, but I don't think they're the same one. So yeah, let's get back to it, boys. So you do have to loosen up that mount, like I said, but then you also have to loosen up these top ones so it drops down a little bit. So now we can put the last of the belts on and then call it good. So yeah, buddy. So let's put these last belts on. Let's do it. All right, boys. So got everything, got that. We just need to torque those down. These are all tightened up, every single thing. So now we can start putting on the front bumper back on. And I think we're pretty much done. Oh, well, putting on paneling right here. I'm just gonna bolt that up real quick. Other than that, it's a wrap. I don't gotta worry about it no more. Lights are in, everything's done. So then after that, we just go take it for a test drive, make sure everything's on, running good. So yeah, so let's keep it. All right, boys, so before we do anything with the car, even started, we're gonna spray it down with some purple power, some degreaser, get it all degreased nice and clean. So yeah, so we're just gonna hit it everywhere. We haven't even started the car, so I'm not too worried about anything, you know, being hot. So we're just gonna get this baby degreased because there is some oil leaking, unless it was like from back in the day or, you know, like from a while ago. I'm not 100% too sure. So we're just gonna get the car degreased. So yeah, let's go. All right, boys. So we just wet it down. It's all wet. Car's on. Let it warm up a little bit. I don't hear any exhaust leak. No exhaust, so just burn it off. So we'll see. So we'll take it around the block once it's done warming up, get the jack out of it, put the hose away, and then yeah, let's go from there.